Get ready to match the stars from We've Got Each Other, Tom Poston, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and from The Betty White Show, Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers!
How are they, John? Are they great? Terrific. Come over here. How are the inmates of the zoo today?
Very well, thank you.
Fine.
Hello. Hello, keeper.
Oh, really? Okay. The great blue heron has spoken. Now, would you join me in greeting Pat Shepard and Scott Stark? Pat here is a very happy lady because she's won two games. She's got $550. And right. That ain't bad,
that's
is it?
Very nice.
Good for
very
you, nice. Pat. And last time we got together, we just met Scott. We found out that he's a student.
That's correct.
And he's studying... now, wait, don't tell me now. He's studying...
Girls.
Drumming.
Girls, right. He's a girl watcher. He loves to watch girls playing tennis. And he is a tennis player, right?
Yes.
And what else about you? I've forgotten.
I'm a student at Pierce College.
I said that.
Hills. Oh, you
yeah.
did.
I said that.
Right. I didn't... Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah. It's all right.
Oh,
okay. Yeah.
Okay. I work part-time in the credit office of a large department store chain.
That's what I forgot.
Do you need a credit card?
No.
Oh, no?
Up to my blank in credit cards. Got all those. Okay. Now, he says he's in love with Marianne Mobley and he wants to give her a kiss, but I don't know if we can allow that.
Well, Allow it.
All right. All right, you can meet halfway. You come over here and stand on this line, and you come over here and you stand on this line. Wait a minute.
She's
hold it right there.
Right.
Nothing
today.
Fancy.
Certainly
I want to see
is.
Daylight. I will hold my hand there, and I want to see light between you at all times. Okay, go. Now, wait a minute. Hold everything. Stop that. Cut that out. Get that.
Thank you, Jim.
What? Cut. All right.
I want to thank you very much. I've been wanting to do that for a long time.
That'll be $40 if you please. All right, we'll start this game. Round one coming up right after we do a little business with you. All right. Here we go. Scott Stark, you may have A or B.
B, please.
B. Oh, I hope it's a good one because you're going to earn your money today, folks. There. Here it is.
Why?
The movie star said... I wanted to do a telethon, and then I found out that all the good diseases were taken. So, my lousy luck, I got stuck with doing a telethon to combat blank.
All the good diseases?
Would you read that again?
He says, I wanted to do a telethon, I found out all the good diseases were taken. My lousy luck, I got stuck with doing a telethon to combat blank.
Well, I'm up a creek.
All the good diseases were taken, so I got stuck with a telethon to combat blank.
Well, that stinks. I wouldn't even steal that.
I don't know
I'm
how to
ready,
spell
Gene.
It.
What did you say, hon?
You're ready. Good for you.
Oh, well.
Well, it's a first round question. Right. Just anything that comes into your head.
Good.
He'll think of one. He will now. He will.
What I
well, I don't.
There's a good.
Oh, kill first.
Okay.
I don't have it.
Right.
I'm not into diseases.
Scott Stark, a movie star, said I wanted to do a telethon. Then I found out that all the good diseases were taken. My lousy luck, I got stuck with doing a telethon to combat blank.
Bad breath.
Bad breath is a good response. Okay. He came up with a pretty good one, Tom.
Yeah, I had bad breath in reverse, but I changed the nature of the disease in my head, you know, because I wanted to go with something that was.
You have hay fever.
Yeah, inconsequential.
Hay fever.
Is that any good?
Yeah, no, that's rotten.
Is that the same as bad breath?
No, that's a little different.
What do you say?
There's a lot of Marion Lorne in Tom Poston.
Yeah, there sure is. Yeah.
And a lot of Tom Poston.
Be very careful.
I said dandruff.
Dandruff is another good response. A lot of good answers here, Charles. Show him another good one.
I can't get dandruff anymore.
Aw. Why?
Well, figure it out. I think it's a match, halitosis.
Halitosis. Thank you. So, Scott, that's one for you.
I'll take it.
I got my lousy luck. I got stuck with doing a telethon to combat bad breath, he says, or halitosis. Either one of those is a match.
And we just kissed.
Yes.
Oh, well, sometimes your best friends won't tell you. No, yeah. I enjoy that, Scott. Yes. Thank you. I thought of a more serious problem.
What is it?
And I'm really ashamed I said it.
Well, I
said body odor.
Oh, yes.
Is that match?
No, it doesn't.
It goes wrong. Oh, yes. I mean, it encompasses everything.
No, it doesn't. Not quite. Okay, Richard.
Halitosis.
You missed it, right?
I was going to say bad breath, but I blew it. I said athlete's foot.
Athlete's foot. So, that's two for him. Pat, now let's see what we've got for you. Ready for yours?
Ready.
Here it is. Hey, did you hear that they just taped the shortest show on television?
No.
Yes. It was when Blank went on to tell the truth. Shortest show on television when Blank went on to tell the truth.
Got it.
Right?
Got it.
Yeah, I see your locket.
Brent Summers, almost gold. Come on.
Well, it's very pretty.
For $4.98, you get the locket. For another $3, you get the watch.
Isn't that cheap looking?
I think it's rather nice myself. So all right, cheap. They're all ready, so here we go. Pat Shepard. Did you hear that you just taped the shortest show ever on television? It was when Blank went on to tell the truth.
Richard Nixon.
Richard Nixon. He says, who's Richard Nixon? That's her answer.
Well, it certainly is mine.
There it is. And a boy, Tom. And yours?
I try never to live in the past, darling. I said Mr. Lance.
Mr. Lance. That's not a bad answer, so don't
bore. It's a wonderful answer and absolutely accurate.
Right. yes.
Mr. Nixon.
So, that's two for her. Score is now tied 2-2. Marianne, show us yours. It was Blank when Blank went on to tell the truth.
Would it really amaze you if I didn't match?
If you didn't match?
Uh-huh.
No, I would expect you not to match.
That's right. Well, you're right. I said Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell. All right.
We have one Howard Cosell fan in the audience.
And you, sir?
I should have said Richard Helms.
Richard Helms, yeah.
Where's it as a badge of honor? But I said Nixon.
All right. Yeah. Thank you, Pat. What do you say to all this, Betty?
RN.
RN, okay. Score is now 4-2. Round two coming up right after we do a little business with you. Here we go. Bing. Bing bong. Scott, you may have A or B.
B again, please.
B it is. Score is 4-2. Round two coming up. Here it is. Richard does not play. Charles does not play. The rest of you, if you please. Listen, you may not know this, but for old time's sake, Lieutenant Kojak keeps a bag of blank in his pocket. Just for old time's sake, Lieutenant Kojak keeps a bag of blank in his pocket. For old time's sake. Right, yes, for all lang syne.
What does he keep in his pocket for new time's sake?
A watch that works.
A watch that works.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Here we go. Scott Stark, you may not know this, but for old time's sake,
please.
Oh, thought you
really,
were
sitting. I'm shocked at
Hold
you.
Everything.
Listen, I just have to think sometimes. Not often, but this is, what is this? This is fall.
Yes. All right, here we go. Oh, for old time's sake, Lieutenant Kojak keeps a bag of blank in his pocket.
Lollipops.
Lollipops. What do you say to that?
Well, I know that that's not the joke for a man with not too much hair.
Right.
But I still said lollipops because...
Right. That's the idea. You matched him.
He's a sucker for a lollipop.
Did you say that? That's
no, you
said... Minus one.
The trick is to match lollipop.
That's true. Score is now 4-4. Mary Ann. Don't expect too much from Mary Ann, Scott. I mean, you got your kiss.
Yeah, that's what I wanted.
And that's it. Okay, show and tell.
Well, I love you, Scott, but I have a problem.
Well,
you
sure.
You see, he always uses the lollipop, so what he's missing is hair.
Hair. That's right. He keeps lollipops with him all the time. But hair is what for old time's sake.
For old time's sake, what? Right. So I must have missed the whole point because I said dandruff.
Dandruff. Another good answer. Now, dandruff and hair were two splendid answers there. Pat Shepard, you're in a catbird seat again. Match one, you win the game. Let's see. Richard does not play. Brett does not play.
No, Brett plays.
Charles doesn't play.
I
Brett
don't play.
Well, Brett plays. And Tom does not
and
play.
And Marianne Mobley.
All right.
Now that everyone's confused, let's go ahead.
It's Brett and Marianne.
Very good,
sweetness. Oh,
shoot. Susie said Herbie treats his house guests like animals. When I went into his guest bathroom, there was blank spread on the floor.
Got it.
Right. Now, Pat Shepard, Susie said Herbie treats his house guests like animals. When I went into his guest bathroom, there was blank spread on the floor.
Newspaper.
Newspaper. Okay. One newspaper will win the game. What do you say?
I'm sorry, Scott, but glad for you, darling. Paper.
Paper. That wins the game for Pat Shepard. What do you have, Mary? There it is. Okay, you get your regular place there. We'll tell Scott that he's going to get some gifts and wish him the very best of luck in his career. You're a nifty kid and a peachy dancer, Scott. Start, ladies and gentlemen.
Can I kiss much. Him goodbye?
Yeah, have a good
time. Good. So long, Scott. Here she is again. There it is, Pat. It's all for you. Let's see how you do this time. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank O. Blank dash O. Blank O. Remember, you got $500 for matching the answer they gave most often, and for the second most popular answer, you got $250, and then for matching the third, you get $100, and remember, you get some help, too.
Yes. Tom, please.
Tom. It's just a verbal response.
Well, she'd like you to answer the question.
Well, I don't know what letter to use. You could use B.
All right.
Is that your answer? B-O?
That could be B. You could use, what, I do more?
Well, no, one is all we need from
okay.
you.
Okay.
Yeah, just say one. That's your answer, B-O.
Well, you could do lots of letters with
those. Sure, of course, naturally. It doesn't have to be another letter. It can be a word, you see, too.
Oh.
Betty.
Who?
Betty.
I'm going to say, as in a football score, zip, 0-0.
Zero
nothing
to zero.
Nothing.
All right.
Oh. And Charles.
What if it looks like that?
Honey, trust me in
okay,
this.
Let's see.
Trust me in this. My favorite person, a person, a man I'm crazy about, whom I wish would call me.
Harry O.
Harry O.
David Jensen.
That's your decision, Charles. Harry O. So you got B-O, Harry O, and
like
Zippo.
Jell-O, Babbo.
Zippo.
I want Jell-O.
You want Jell-O. Oh. Very good answer.
That's the best one.
That sounds like a winner to me. Sound like a winner to you? Yeah. Good. All right, let's see if we got that shimmery stuff under the $100 response. Ariel, there's Brett's answer and Charles' answer.
Thank
let's see
you.
The $250 response. Spaghetti-o.
Oh, no.
All right. You think it's going to be there?
Come on.
Well, if it's not Jell-O, what else can it be?
Jerry-o.
Slide it. Hawaii Five-O. Big popular TV show, Hawaii Five-0. So there it is. Gee, I'm sorry, Pat, you struck out here. Listen, you've picked up an additional amount of money. You got up to $650 now, and we're going to do a little business with America, and then you'll meet another player, okay? Come right back. Again is Gene Reagan. Thank you, Johnny. Oh, now here we go. Let's all applaud our new player here, Christy Piper. Hi, Christy.
Hi.
Well, you're a beauty. Where are you from?
I'm from Hermosa Beach.
Where?
Hermosa Beach.
Oh, Hermosa Beach.
Yes.
South of here, right?
Yes, south.
Are you a student?
No, I'm not. I'm a director of food service for a major Mexican restaurant chain in Southern California.
No kidding.
Yes.
Yeah. Director of food service.
Yes.
You buy the food?
No, I just make sure that when...
Turn the light off. Don't turn that light off on that lady.
That
her face just went dark. There. Okay, thank you.
Just make sure that when you get it, that it's right. That it's perfect.
Oh, good for you. Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, that's wonderful.
Could you come help me in my house?
All right, Christy, good luck to you. I'll ask you to
Could
make
you
a selection.
Could you come help me
here.
In my house?
Watch it, Tom.
Cut it. Cut. A or B, my dear?
B, please.
B it is. B. Bay, as we say in Spanish. Ah, bay. Ugly Edna's father works in the post office.
Yeah.
And that's why... When Edna was born, he stamped blank on her bottom. You do understand, don't you?
What was his name? His name?
Ugly Edna's father.
Ugly Edna, uh-huh.
Works in the post office, and that's why when Edna was born, he stamped blank on her bottom.
Okay.
Ugly Edna's father. Ugly Edna.
Oh, I know what I,
All right. Now, Christy, Ugly Edna's father works in the post office, and that's why when Edna was born, he stamped blank on her bottom.
Handle with care?
Handle with care is one good response, yep. They have all of those stamps. You may find some other more interesting ones over here, Tom.
Well, since you said that she was ugly,
yeah.
That wouldn't mean anything to a father who really loved her. But just for a laugh, I put return to sender.
Return to sender. Okay, Brett?
Well, since you said she was ugly,
right.
I figured her father would say to hell with it and send her back.
Return to sender. Little joke. No one would ever do a terrible thing like that, Charles.
Why not?
Handle
I'm trying to save you. Yes.
The handle with care was such a lovely poignant. As we're approaching the holiday season, I was so moved. I chose something. I wish Patty Duke were here to see this. I chose something similar. Fragile.
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 Babies are fragile.
Don't call us. We'll call you.
Handle with care is what Christy wants. What do you say, Marianne?
Well, I'm sorry, but she was so ugly.
That?
And you know you can't send her back.
Right.
So the next best thing is to say, address unknown.
Okay. All kinds of possibilities here.
Return to sender.
Return to sender. And you, Betty?
I have an Emmy for Charles's performance.
There it is.
Beautiful.
Emmy.
Return to sender.
I know you got enough of
them. Return to sender. So now yours will be along in a moment. Right now we got to do a little business with you. Listen, we don't have time to do another question. Is there anything you'd like to say before we say goodbye?
It's not as easy as it looks.
Yeah, well, now that's
this game
a
is
candid.
Not as easy as it yeah. looks.
Why is that? You get up here and you can't think?
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you think of any other answers other than the one you gave us just now?
No, that was the only one. That
yeah.
was the only one I
All
could
right.
think of.
Well, listen, the second round ones will get a little bit easier,
right.
and we'll look forward to seeing both of you ladies next time. Look forward to seeing Tom Poston on We've Got Each Other on CBS Saturday nights, 8:30 Eastern, 7:30 yeah. Western and Central.
Brett and I have no shows.
You have no shows?
No, Richard does. Everyone has shows.
Richard has
Betty
his show. Betty White has her own, the Betty White show, and also on CBS.
We have nothing.
If some producer is watching out there, these two people. Oh, you don't?
No,
we
can
all... chop liver?
We don't want
Yes. What, you have a show?
Yes.
What?
The Collins Family plays every night of the week. Up on
okay.
Hutton Drive.
All right. That's still, we still got 30 seconds.
We still have, could I
one stage manager is giving me 30 seconds, and the other one on this side is giving me 15 seconds. Well, you guys make up your mind. How much time?
Well,
10 seconds.
15 away. What have you got?
Happy birthday, Ma.
Time to say bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Join us next time, Match Game 77. Goodbye.